Artificial intelligence has an environment problem. It's partly to blame for electricity use going up fast around the world. In fact, by next year, experts are worried that AI powering data centers are going to consume as much electricity as all of Japan.
That is wild. Michelle Beck explains what's behind that alarming prediction and gets an inside look at a possible energy saving solution being developed right here in Minnesota.
You need a world-class thin film deposition system. Luckily, we have this system.
Professor Janping Wang tells us to suit up.
And for this clean room.
For in this University of Minnesota lab.
Yeah, airborne particle.
We pose a threat. Human germs must be blocked because this machine is creating something that must not be disturbed.
How cool is it that the theory that you developed upstairs, you can see it in real time down here?
That's very exciting. Yeah.
Wang and his team built devices using brand new physics. It's all part of the work to rethink computing, helping the process save a lot of energy.
We can reduce energy consumption by 1,000 times. For some applications, even more.
Environmental concerns are growing, and AI is making them worse.
Here's what I mean. Let's compare a typical Google search with an AI search. A typical ChatGPT request uses up 10 times more electricity than a Google search. It needs far more computing power and data to process.
According to the International Energy Agency, between 2022 and 2026, data centers that power AI will use up twice as much electricity.
We need to do something about it if we want to keep using AI.
U of M professor Ulia Karpuściu is an expert in energy-efficient computer system design. Tapped to take part in Wang's groundbreaking research, she worries over another resource getting consumed by AI. Water. That's how computers cool down when they heat up. In fact, this is what you get when you combine all the water going to generative AI.
It can exceed the total water consumption of countries like Denmark.
Does that shock you, scare you?
As an engineer, it motivates me.
There's much to solve, as energy is a deeply rooted problem in computing.
Based on the so-called von Neumann model,
all modern computers from smartphones to data centers work like this. Data lives in one place and it's processed in another. It takes a lot of energy to move back and forth.
Unintentionally, this is the very reason why AI is not very energy efficient right now.
This is one of the chief reasons.
So what if data doesn't need to move around wasting energy? Wang's new thinking is to have data live and get processed in the same place within memory.
This is an array of the magnetic tunnel junction, and the magnetic tunnel junction is a building block of a memory cell.
Make computing more energy efficient, it'll consume less electricity and less water.
I'm crazy enough, started this work almost 22 years ago, and no one think using memory cell can do computing. Now finally we demonstrate that.
Think bigger when considering the human threat. How we use AI is impacting the planet. Will it be sustainable?
That's a $100 billion question, right? But I need to solve this problem from my own expertise.
So Professor Wang there says his work is backed by industry leaders, including names like Intel. So when might we see his research in real life? Well, due to all the demand, Wang says the timeline's been fast-forwarded, and it could be as short as 5 years.
Can't come soon enough, because AI just continues to grow and grow, and we're using it more and more often.
So much. It's shocking to me that if you Google something, it's using less energy than AI. And we all Google stuff all the time.
Yeah.
Wow. So